أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ياسين والقرآن الحكيم. إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم. تنزيل العزيز الرحيم. لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون. لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون. إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون. وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون. وسواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. إنما تنذر من اتبع الذكر وخشي الرحمن بالغيب فبشره بمغفرة وأجر كريم. إنا نحن نحيي الموتى ونكتب ما قدموا وآثارهم وكل شيء أحصيناه في إمام مبين. واضرب لهم مثلا أصحاب القرية إذ جاءها المرسلون. إذ أرسلنا إليهم اثنين فكذبوهما فعززنا بثالث فقالوا إنا إليكم مرسلون. قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء إن أنتم إلا تكذبون. قالوا ربنا يعلم إنا إليكم لمرسلون وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين. قالوا إنا تطيرنا بكم لئن لم تنتهوا لنرجمنكم وليمسنكم منا عذاب أليم. قالوا طائركم معكم أئن ذكرتم بل أنتم قوم مسرفون. وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى قال يا قوم اتبعوا المرسلين. اتبعوا من لا يسألكم أجرا وهم مهتدون. وما لي لا أعبد الذي فطرني وإليه ترجعون. أأتخذ من دونه آلهة إن يردني الرحمن بضر لا تغن عني شفاعتهم شيئا ولا ينقذون. إني إذا لفي ضلال مبين. إني آمنت بربكم فاسمعون. قيل ادخل الجنة قال يا ليت قومي يعلمون. بما غفر لي ربي وجعلني من المكرمين. وما أنزلنا على قومه من بعده من جند من السماء وما كنا منزلين إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم خامدون يا حسرة على العباد ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون ألم يروا كم أهلكنا قبلهم من القرون أنهم إليهم لا يرجعون وإن كل لما جميع لدينا محضرون وآية لهم الأرض الميتة أحييناها وأخرجنا منها حبا فمنه يأكلون وجعلنا فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب وفجرنا فيها من العيون ليأكلوا من ثمره وما عملته أيديهم أفلا يشكرون سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض ومن أنفسهم ومما لا يعلمون وآية لهم الليل نسلخ منه النهار فإذا هم مظلمون والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم لا الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر ولا الليل سابق النهار وكل في فلك يسبحون وآية لهم أنا حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون وخلقنا لهم من مثله ما يركبون وإن نشأ نغرقهم فلا صريخ لهم ولا هم ينقذون إلا رحمة منا ومتاعا إلى حين وإذا قيل لهم اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم لعلكم ترحمون وما تأتيهم من آية من آيات ربهم إلا كانوا عنها معرضين وإذا قيل لهم أنفقوا مما رزقكم الله قال الذين كفروا للذين آمنوا أنطعم من لو يشاء الله أطعمه إن أنتم إلا في ضلال مبين ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين ما ينذرون إلا صيحة واحدة تأخذهم وهم يخصمون فلا يستطيعون توصية ولا إلى أهلهم يرجعون ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون هم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام قولا من رب رحيم. وامتازوا اليوم أيها المجرمون. ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم ألا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين. وأن اعبدوني هذا صراط مستقيم. ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا أفلم تكونوا تعقلون. هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون. اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون. اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون. ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون. ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون. ومن نعمره ننكسه في الخلق أفلا يعقلون. وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين. لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين. أولم يروا أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون. وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون. ولهم فيها منافع ومشارب أفلا يشكرون. واتخذوا من دون الله آلهة لعلهم ينصرون. لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون. فلا يحزنك قولهم إنا نعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون. أولم يرى الإنسان أنا خلقناه من نطفة فإذا هو خصيم مبين. وضرب لنا مثلا ونسي خلقه قال من يحيي العظام وهي رميم. قل يحييها الذي أنشأها أول مرة وهو بكل خلق عليم. الذي جعل لكم من الشجر الأخضر نارا فإذا أنتم منه توقدون. أوليس الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم؟ بلى وهو الخلاق العليم. إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون. فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون. صدق الله العظيم. اللهم آمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. اللهم إنا نستحفظك ونستودعك أدياننا وأبداننا وأنفسنا وأهلنا وأولادنا وأولادنا وأموالنا وكل شيء أعطيتنا. اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم في كنفك وأمانك وعياذك من كل شيطان مريد وجبار عنيد وذي بغي وذي حسد ومن شر كل ذي شر إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم جملنا بالعافية والسلامة وحققنا بالتقوى والاستقامة وأعذنا من موجبات الندامة إنك سميع الدعاء. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وأولادنا ومشايخنا وأصحابنا وإخواننا في الدين ولمن أحبنا فيك ولمن أحسن إلينا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وارزقنا كمال المتابعة له ظاهرا وباطنا في عافية وسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. يا الله يا الله يا الله. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله. اللهم آمين آمين آمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله هو خيرا وأعظم أجرا واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم. أستغفر الله 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 العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله، 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 سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. 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 فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا علي يا عظيم يا حليم يا عليم، أنت ربي وعلمك حسبي، فنعم الرب ربي ونعم الحسب حسبي. تنصر من تشاء وأنت العزيز الرحيم. نسألك العصمة في الحركات والسكنات والكلمات والإرادات والخطرات، من الشكوك والظنون والأوهام الساترة للقلوب عن مطالعة الغيوب. فقد ابتلي المؤمنون وزلزلوا زلزالا شديدا، وإذ يقول المنافقون والذين في قلوبهم مرض ما وعدنا الله ورسوله إلا غرورا. فثبتنا وانصرنا وسخر لنا هذا البحر كما سخرت البحر لموسى، وسخرت النار لإبراهيم، وسخرت الجبال والحديد لداود، وسخرت الريح والشياطين والجن لسليمان. وسخر لنا كل بحر هو لك في الأرض والسماء والملك والملكوت، وبحر الدنيا وبحر الآخرة. وسخر لنا كل شيء، يا من بيده ملكوت كل شيء. كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد. انصرنا فإنك خير الناصرين، وافتح لنا فإنك خير الفاتحين، واغفر لنا فإنك خير الغافرين، وارحمنا فإنك خير الراحمين، وارزقنا فإنك خير الرازقين، واهدنا ونجنا من القوم الظالمين، وهب لنا ريحا طيبة كما هي في علمك، وانشرها علينا من خزائن رحمتك، واحملنا بها حمل الكرامة مع السلامة والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم يسر لنا أمورنا مع الراحة لقلوبنا وأبداننا، والسلامة والعافية في دنيانا ودينينا، وكن لنا صاحبا في سفرنا، وخليفة في أهلنا، واطمس على وجوه أعدائنا وامسخهم على مكانتهم فلا يستطيعون المضي ولا المجيء إلينا ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ياسين والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم تنزيل العزيز الرحيم لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وقد خاب من حمل ظلما طاسين حاميم عين سين قاف مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان حاميم 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 هم الأمر وجاء النصر فعلينا لا ينصرون حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير بسم الله بابنا تبارك حيطاننا ياسين سقفنا كاف ها يا عين صاد كفايتنا حاميم عين سين قاف حمايتنا فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم ستر العرش مسبول علينا وعين الله ناظرة إلينا بحول الله لا يقدر علينا والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في في لوح محفوظ. فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين. فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين. فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين. إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين. إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين. إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين. حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. بسم الله والحمد لله رب العالمين.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله لطيف بعباده يرزق من يشاء وهو القوي العزيز. يا لطيف 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 يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير اللهم يا من لطفت في خلق السماوات والأرض ولطفت بالأجنة في بطون أمهاتها ألطف بنا لطفا يليق بكرمك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا الله اللهم يا من جعلت الصلاة على النبي من القربات نتقرب إليك بكل صلاة سليت عليه من أول النشأة إلى ما لا نهاية من الكمالات بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك.
إن شاء الله we'll continue with ذكر جامعة. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وَسِعَهُ عِلْمُ اللَّهِ. Inshallah, we'll make dua now. اللهم آمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our Shaykh, teacher, murshid, and master, Sayyidina Shaykh Faisal Hamid Abdul Razak. O Allah, may you increase him in knowledge and wisdom. O Allah, may you protect him from evil, and we pray that he will lead his murids on the straight path towards you. O Allah, we pray for the Shaykh and his family. We pray that you strengthen them in Iman, keep them in good health, and grant them long life in Islam. O Allah, we pray that you protect them from all evil, ease their trials, and grant them the sweetness of paradise. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. O Allah, forgive us for our sins and guide us on the straight path leading to paradise. O Allah, you know the needs of all of us present here. O Allah, answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our parents that you grant them your grace and mercy as they raised us in childhood. O Allah, grant our parents long life and good health in Islam. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive our parents and grant them paradise. O Allah, for our parents who have passed away and returned to you, O Allah, we beg you to forgive them. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the murids of Shaykh Faisal throughout the world. O Allah, we pray that you ease our trials and grant us the strength to face our trials. O Allah, make it easy for us to gain true knowledge and to practice it, to be good murids and to get ever closer to you. O Allah, you know the needs of all of the murids. O Allah, we beg you to answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the Muslims around the world. O Allah, we pray that you strengthen us in Iman. O Allah, we pray for unity and to make us stronger as a nation. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, please comfort and relieve all Muslims who are suffering and have suffered losses. O Allah, you are the all-powerful and the almighty. O Allah, we beg you to give us victory against the unbelievers. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for the International Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa. May you make it easy for us to establish many masjids for your sake. May you bless the Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa to be a beacon of light for Islam throughout the world. And may you help us to finish building the new masjid soon and make it easy for us to do so. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadan wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al-mursani walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله
اللهم آمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد صاحب التاج والمعراج والبراك والعلم دافع البلاء والوباء والقحط والمرض والألم اسمه مكتوب مرفوع مشفوع منكوش في اللوح والقلم سيد العرب والعجم جسمه مقدس معتر مطهر منور في البيت والحرم شمس الدحى بدر الدجى صدر العلا نور الهدى كهف الورى مصباح الظلم جميل الشيم شفيع الأمم صاحب الجود والكرم والله عاصمه وجبريل خادمه والبراق مركبه والمعراج سفره وسدرة المنتهى مقامه وقاب قوسين مطلوبه والمطلوب مقصوده والمقصود موجوده سيد المرسلين خاتم النبيين شفيع المذنبين أنيس الغريبين رحمة للعالمين راحة العاشقين مراد المشتاقين شمس العارفين سراج السالكين مصباح المقربين محب الفقراء والغرباء والمساكين سيد الثقلين نبي الحرمين إمام القبلتين وسيلتنا في الدارين وسيلتنا في الدارين صاحب قاب قوسين محبوب رب المشرقين والمغربين جد الحسن والحسين جد الحسن والحسين مولانا ومولى الثقلين أبي القاسم محمد بن عبد الله نور من نور الله نور من نور الله يا أيها المشتاقون بنور جماله صلوا عليه وآله وأصحابه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين آمين آمين
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا اللهم أعذنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأصلح لنا شأننا كله لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين آمين آمين أما بعد My dear respected brothers and sisters, my dear murids, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. And welcome once again to this special program coming to you from the Islamic Forum of Canada, where we share with you this message of mercy from God Almighty to all of His creation. This is our daily broadcast. We start at 7 p.m. Toronto time or Eastern time every day. And we come to you from your Zawiya here at the Islamic Forum. We thank you for joining us today for our broadcast. And we hope you can join us every day for this program, 7 p.m. Toronto time. We kindly request you to reach out to others, to tell your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims that you know to watch the program. Share the YouTube link with them, youtube.com/Sheikh Faisal. And inshallah, they will look at the program. They will benefit, and you will receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do remember to subscribe to the channel. There's a subscribe button. You click on that button to subscribe. And then next to the subscribe button, there's a bell icon. Click on the bell icon and select all for notifications so that you'll be notified of all our different programs. We also kindly request you to enter your information in the chat, your name and city where you're from, and then your updates on the three projects, the Gratitude Project, the Salawat Project, and the Quran Project. You enter your update on the project, inshallah, the three projects. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for so doing. We want to recognize all the sponsors for the dinner program, all those families and especially sisters that have sponsored the dinner program. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. And we want to recognize as well all our donors, those who donated today and yesterday and before to the Islamic Forum. And we make special dua for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all our donors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer the dua and grant them special blessings and ni'mah and bounties and grace, our donors and their families and loved ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and increase them in His bounties, increase them in His risk, grant them more wealth, much more than what they donate to the Islamic Forum. So we make special dua for all our donors, and we thank them and we appreciate their financial support for the Islamic Forum. I also want to remind you what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in the hadith, ma naqasa malin bi sadaqah. Your wealth will never decrease because of spending it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ma naqasa malin bi sadaqah. The sadaqah that you give will never cause your wealth to decrease. It will increase your wealth. And the scholars have said that your wealth doesn't decrease. It means indeed, certainly, surely your wealth will increase. This is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ma naqasa malin bi sadaqah. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in the hadith. And the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the ayatul infaq, the ayah of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will never attain true piety, birr, unless and until you spend what you love. You spend a portion of your wealth for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we invite you to donate regularly and generously to the Islamic Forum, and we make special dua for you. I also want to reassure you that your safety, your well-being, your health, as well as your spirituality, that's the concern of our program. This program focuses on taking care of your safety, your well-being, your afia, as well as your spirituality, that you can be in good health and you can be safe, and you can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you from all sources of harm. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants you that great blessing of spirituality, your connection with him, your connection with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so every day we make this special dua for you, for your safety, your spirituality, and so on, that you can be granted the goodness of this world and the goodness of the hereafter. And that's the comprehensive dua for the believers that's mentioned in the Quran. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. This is a comprehensive dua. It's called a dua al-jami'a, the comprehensive dua, because it contains everything you can ask for to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's contained in this dua, the comprehensive dua. We also have a special series of beautiful short video clips prepared by our staff here at the Islamic Forum for your viewing, enjoyment, and benefit. Short video clips of interesting, relevant, beautiful topics that you can benefit from and you can share with others. As well as we have a special series of video lectures on the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and all of that is a gift for you, free of charge. It's for anyone, inshallah. So if you would like to receive these special video clips and a special series of seerah lectures, then please send us your email address so we can send it to you, inshallah. Beautiful video clips and video lectures that our staff have prepared especially for you. I would like now to make a special dua for each and every one of you. Dua for all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before. All our donors without exception. And then special dua for the sponsors of our dinner program. And then special dua for all those who entered their information in the chat. And for each and every one of you, I want to make special dua for each and every one of you. Whatever dua you want to make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, put that niyyah in your heart for that dua, and we'll make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on your niyyah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can accept your dua and grant you everything you ask for. And also, I want to include in my dua for my family and my parents, my mother and my father. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, and please do mention them and remember them in your dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for so doing. So kindly raise your hands and join me in dua. Allahumma ameen. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. اللهم إنا نستحفظك ونستودعك أدياننا وأبداننا وأنفسنا وأهلنا وأولادنا وأموالنا وكل شيء أعطيتنا. اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم في كنفك وأمانك وعياذك من كل شيطان مريد وجبار عنيد وذي بغي وذي حسد ومن شر كل ذي شر إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم جملنا بالعافية والسلامة وحققنا بالتقوى والاستقامة وأعذنا من موجبات الندامة إنك سميع الدعاء. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وأولادنا ومشايخنا وأصحابنا وإخواننا في الدين ولمن أحبنا فيك ولمن أحسن إلينا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب دعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وارزقنا كمال المتابعة له ظاهرا وباتنا في عافية وسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله. اللهم آمين آمين آمين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in tawfiq and in qubul and in ziyada. Ameen, ameen. I also want to remind you of our ongoing projects, the action item we have ongoing for our program, the three projects, the gratitude project, the salawat project, and the Quran project. For you to engage in these projects regularly on a daily basis, and then you enter your update in the chat, inshallah. Today I want to say something about the Salawat project, to focus on the Salawat project, to talk something about the beautiful, amazing virtues of Salawat, on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to recite Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin abdika wa rasulika nabiyil ummi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Many are the great virtues of salawat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the Quran the ayah of salawat in Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter 33, verse 56, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals, Bismillah ar-Rahim,
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد. Yes, many are the great virtues and blessings and benefits of reciting salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Among them, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned these in the hadith. When you send one salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends 10 salawat upon you. Look at the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You send one salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends 10 salawat upon you. When you send one salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants you 10 hasanat, 10 good deeds are recorded for you when you send one salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When you send one salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, 10 sayyiat, 10 bad deeds and sins are erased from your records. So you're forgiven, and then bad deed is erased from your records, never to be heard of about in the dunya and in the akhirah, especially in the akhirah and the day of judgment. And when you send one salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates you 10 degrees higher. You're raised up 10 degrees more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such indeed are the great benefits and blessings of salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In addition to that, your dua is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you precede your dua with salawat and you end your dua with salawat. So you sandwich your dua in between salawat, as we do in our dua all the time. So at the beginning, hamd and salawat, then make whatever dua you want to make, and then salawat and hamd at the end. In this manner, it's from the adab of dua that your dua, and when you do it like this, your dua is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the dua of salawat, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, you're saying, that dua of salawat is guaranteed acceptance by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when it's placed before and after whatever dua you want to make, it raises up your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It elevates your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It takes up your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is accepted in that way. And then the salawat grants you nearness to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of judgment. He says in the hadith, "Awla an-nasi bi yawm al-qiyamati aktharuhum alayya salatan." The closest of people to me on the day of judgment, the nearest of people to me on the day of judgment, are those who are most frequent in reciting salawat upon me. This is the great blessing of reciting salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, you get closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The hadith speaks of the day of judgment, but even in this dunya, you get closer to the Prophet ﷺ every time you recite salawat on the Prophet ﷺ. Closeness in the dunya, closeness in the akhirah. How close do you want to be to the Prophet ﷺ and to his noble Ahlul Bayt and to the Sahabas, the awliya? Yes, how close you want to be to the Prophet ﷺ? You answer that question, and then you decide how much salawat you want to recite on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because every time you're reciting salawat, you're getting closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine yourself on the day of judgment, and there are billions of people there, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in the center on the beautiful carriage, the most beautiful carriage you'll ever see, tied to the burak. That's the carriage of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's holding Liwa ul Hamd, the banner of praise that is given on that day of judgment, making him demonstrating that he is the leader of everything and everyone on that day of judgment. as your Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, how close do you want to be to him? Wouldn't you like for you to be close to him? You can see him and he can see you. You're close to him, you can see him, you can see the Ahlul Bayt on that carriage with him, the prophetic entourage, Sayyidina Fatima al-Zahra, Sayyidina Ali al-Murtada, Sayyidina Imam Hassan, Sayyidina Imam Hussein, and so on. Ahlul Bayt are there with the Prophet Of course, we would love to be close to him. And every time you recite salawat, you're getting closer to the Prophet. So I want you to recite salawat as much as you can. As part of this salawat project, every day you recite your salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and honor you to be able to recite salawat on his most beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Shukran. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله
صلوا على رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد أشرف العرب والعجم محمد خير من يمشي على قدمي محمد بسيط المعروف جامعه محمد صاحب الإحسان والكرم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد تجرس لله قاطبة محمد صادق الأقوال والكلم محمد ثابت الميثاق حافظه محمد طيب الأخلاق والشيم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد جبلت بالنور تينته محمد لم يزل نورا من القدم محمد حكيم بالعدل ذو شرف محمد مدين الإنعام والحكم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد خير خلق الله من مضر محمد خير رسل الله كلهم محمد دينه حق ندين به محمد مشرك حقا على عالم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد ذكره روح لأنفسنا محمد شكره فرض على الأمم محمد رحيم الله العباد به محمد سبب الإنشاء من عدم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله.
لا إله إلا الله 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 سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت يا حي يا قيوم إذا شئت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا
اللهم أعزنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، وأصلح لنا شأننا كله. لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. آمين آمين. أما بعد، My dear respected brothers and sisters, I greet you with the greetings of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. And welcome once again to this special series of lectures on the life and teachings of the noble Sheikh, His Eminence Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani, Sultan Al-Awliya Al-Ghaws Al-Azam radiallahu anhu. Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani migrated from his hometown of Jilan to Baghdad, the capital of the Islamic Empire at that time. When he was 18 years of age, he spent then 73 years of his life in Baghdad, so most of his life. His heritage is Baghdad that he left. He spent 73 years of his life in Baghdad. When he came to Baghdad, the Abbasid Khilafah, or Khilafah al-Abbasiyyah, was ruling the Muslim world then. And when he arrived, 18 years of age, a young man at that time, the Khalifa Mustahdhir Billahi Abu al-Abbas was ruling. He was the Khalifa, or the king, at that time. And after him, four other Khalifas of the Khilafa al-Abbasiyyah ruled. And they were al-Mustarshid Billah, firstly, then al-Rashid Billah, then thirdly, al-Muqtafi li Amrillah, and fourthly, al-Mustanjid Billah. They had these names, which were like titles for them, as the Khalifa of the Muslim world. And they succeeded one after another in that way. But then there were some problems between the Khilafa al-Abbasiyyah and the Seljukid kings. They were competing with Egypt, with one another for power, for ruling the Muslim world and so on. And it became very heart-rending to the Sheikh to witness these feuds and infighting and sometimes cruel savagery and treachery among the leaders of that time, those who were competing for power. And the people got caught up in this. People usually follow the ways of their leaders. And there's a hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in which he says, he's reported to have said, كَمَا تَكُونُ يُصَلِّتَ عَلَيْكُمْ. As you are, that is how your leaders will be. If people are pious and good, then usually they would get good rulers, good leaders at some point in time. But if people are corrupted and evil and so on, then that's the type of leader they would get. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned this in the hadith. And so Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani was affected tremendously by this state of affairs that he saw among the leaders. He himself kept away from the leaders. He wouldn't visit their court, wouldn't accept gifts from them, would stay aloof from them. And even when they attended his dars, as many of them would and often would do so, the kings and ministers of the government and so on, they would sit down with the rest of the people in that way. He wouldn't show them any different treatment and so on. He actually would spend his time with the poor people and his students and so on in the dars, or the gatherings for his dars that he would have. But
what he did, and he had nothing to do with these struggles for power among the politicians, but he saw the suffering of the people because of these problems. And so he dedicated himself through his sermons, his speeches, his khutbas, to revive and reform the people. That was his technique of changing or responding to the situation. That he would educate the people, look at the problems that people were suffering from, and address those problems in a practical way, educate them according to Islam, Quran, and Sunnah, so that the people would return back to the right with the Sirat al-Mustaqim. And based on this conviction, this understanding of the Shaykh, that if people are reformed, then society will be reformed, then the leadership of society will be reformed as well. But it starts with the individual. This individual Muslim, this individual believer must reform himself or herself in order to see such reforms in society. He would explain to people about the temporary nature of this world and the fleeting pleasures of this world that people are so much preoccupied with. But he would tell them these are temporary things. They come and they go. And there is no need for coveting one another over these things, but focus on the eternal bliss of the hereafter and focus on preparing for the life to come, the life of the hereafter. And so his sermons was dedicated to this. The discourses and sermons of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani had a magnetic effect, which is still discernible in these speeches today. When we read them, you can feel that sense of magnetism in the lecture, that he wielded that influence on the people of his time. And as you mentioned, scholars would say that when the Sheikh was giving his dars, his lectures, it would seem as if all of Baghdad was there listening to him. The crowds were so large, thousands and thousands of people would come and listen to him. Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani is perhaps best in two of his outstanding books, Futuhul Ghaib and Al-Fathur Rabbani. Beautiful books with amazing lessons. And it seems as if in describing the law for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the tawheed, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it seemed as if he was inspired by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in what he was saying. And so following in the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and those who succeeded the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sahabas, the Tabi'een, and so on, Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani dealt with the current problems of his days, the current situation of his time, analyzed the reasons for the miseries and maladies of the people, and provided answers to them, how they should respond to these problems, weaknesses, spiritual diseases they suffered from. Along with this, the tremendous sincerity and earnest zeal for the welfare of the people inspired him with a frenzy of enthusiasm and magnetic effect capable of influencing the hearts of people. And this is exactly what he did. He influenced the hearts of the people. He would explain to them the concept of Tawheed and its ramifications in their life. Tawheed, La ilaha illallah, and how that ought to impact the people in their life. The forces of materialism, of worldliness, had become so strong during the time of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani that the entire social and economic life in the community appeared to be connected, to be woven in the political situation of the time. In other words, people are consumed by what is happening with their leaders, and the leaders are fighting and competing with one another who would be leaders and so on. And the people got involved in that, even in the fighting, one side against another. And these are Muslims fighting Muslims. Yes, that was the sad situation he noticed, and he said, but he did something about the situation. he set about to reform the people to change that situation. And ultimately, he did achieve that. People had developed a tendency of depending upon the kings and nobles of their time for the realization of their worldly ends, and had begun to treat these politicians and leaders as the ultimate dispensers of benefit and harm. And so, in one of his sermons, in order to counteract this mistaken tendency in the people, he said that this entire creation is like a man who has been imprisoned and chained by a king whose dominions are vast. The prisoner has been hung from a pine tree, beneath which flows a river wide and deep. The king is seated on an elevated chair, having arrows and bows, javelins and spears by his side. He hits the captive with whatever weapon he desires. Now, would it be prudent for anyone witnessing this scene to divert his attention from the king and expect harm or favor from the captive instead of the king? Because the captive is at the mercy of the king. The captive is tied up, hanging from a tree below the river. If he fall in there, he'll die. And the king is standing up on an elevated chair, ready to puncture him and having weapons to injure him in whatever way he wants. So the sheikh is saying, don't expect that a man in such a situation to divert his attention from the king, because the king is between him, his life, and his death. So he's totally focused there. And so he's telling people that this is what is happening to them now, that if they allow themselves to be held captive by the rulers of their time, this is the situation they will find themselves in. And so he turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dua, as he's teaching the people now, even through dua, how they should be. He says in this dua, mentioned in Futuhul Ghaib, O Almighty Allah, I seek your refuge from blindness after having been given eyes and given sight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him sight, eyesight. And so he seeks refuge in Allah from becoming blind. And different types of blindness. There's a physical blindness, but there's some other blindness that are much more severe and serious and more consequential than that. Spiritual blindness being at the head of the list. That if someone is spiritually blind, then their existence is one of total loss in the dunya and in the akhirah. So he says, Almighty Allah, seek your refuge from blindness after having been given sight. I seek your refuge and protection from being cast off after getting near to you. After you brought me near to you, Allah, don't let me go away again. Don't let me go astray. Don't let me be misguided after you've brought me to you. As the beautiful Quranic dua says, رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. Yes, yeah, Allah, after you've guided us to you, don't cause our hearts to go astray. لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. You've guided us to Islam. We're believers, we're Muslims, we're worshipping you, we're near to you. Don't let us go astray or be led astray. This is the beautiful dua of Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. He continues, Ya Allah, O Almighty Allah, I seek refuge in you. I seek your protection from regression after being promoted to your favor. After receiving your favor, I seek your protection from you from losing that favor, from losing that favor. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Quran that if he gives you a ni'mah, if he gives you a ni'mah, a favor, a bounty, a blessing, he would not take it away from you so long as you keep thanking him for that bounty and favor. لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. This is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are thankful to me, I will increase you with my bounties upon you. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he would not change the condition of a people unless they change themselves. So if you are receiving a bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a result of obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you continue to obey Allah and to be sincere with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he'll keep giving you that bounty. It is only when you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you turn away from Allah, then he turns away from you and take away his bounties from you. So this is the dua that Sayyidi Sheikh Qabil Jilani is making to seek the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from that happening. He says, "Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you, I seek protection in you from being misled after obtaining your guidance." That when we are guided to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, we should be mindful not to be misguided by others, misled by others. Other people, other things take us astray from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, take us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Quranic dua, Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي هَدَانَ لِهَذَا وَمَا كُنَّا لِنَهَتَدِيَ لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَ اللَّهِ. Praise be to Allah who's guided me to this, to Islam, to being Muslim. And I could never have been guided if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not guide me to Islam. No one can be guided to Islam if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't guide them to Islam. So there's that appeal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you want to keep receiving the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not to be led astray by others. So the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that someone can say something to us, do something, and we follow them. We do the wrong thing, we are led astray, that we should be mindful of. O Allah, I seek refuge in you, I seek a protection from apostasy after I have been granted faith. Yes, the guidance comes only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can guide someone to Islam. And so he's seeking protection from losing that great ni'mah, that great bounty of guidance, of hidayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to turn to misguidance, to turn to disbelief after they've been guided to Islam. And there's some people like that, unfortunately. They're Muslims, they grew up in Muslim homes, and then they decide to become non-Muslims, to sometimes disbelieve in Allah or choose another path to their detriment. So the beautiful dua of the Sheikh, Sidi Abdul Qadir, Sheikh Sayyidi Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, radiyallahu anhu. Now, when you look at the dua, you can see that he is also teaching people how to strive to become in the dua, what he's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. And it's responding to the misguidance prevalent in his time. He also focused on teaching people to develop exclusive love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that excludes other things other than Allah. So in another sermon, also in Futuhul Ghaib, he mentions to people, asking them to instill the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mahabbatullah, in their hearts. He said, "Keep your eyes fixed on him who is looking at you." Him meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of everyone. Among his descriptions, his attributes, he is al-basir, the all-seeing one. He sees everything, everyone. So the Sheikh is mentioning, keep your eyes fixed on him who is looking at you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at us. Wherever we are, however we are, no one can hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, keep your eyes fixed on him who is looking at you. Keep yourself before the one who keeps himself before you. Before the one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is always there in front of you. In the hadith, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned to Sayyidina Anas, احفظ الله يحفظك. That you be mindful to be with Allah. You'll find him in front. Tajidhu amamak. You'll find him in front of you. He'll protect you. Yahfadak. Like this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How he relates to us when we relate to him in this way. That we feel that we're in the presence of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pulls us into his presence. Yes. Keep your eyes fixed on the one, Allah, who is looking at you. Keep yourself before the one, Allah, who keeps himself before you. Love him who loves you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you, so love him. Let your heart be outpouring, outflowing with mahabba, with love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respond to him who responds to you, who calls you. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, that he responds to us when we call him. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانَ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the ayat in Surah Al-Baqarah, in the section of about Siyam, about fasting in Ramadan. Yes, if my servant calls on me, say I'm near to them. I respond, I answer them, their dua, their what they're asking for, I answer them. Therefore, call upon me. Yes, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us. So respond to him, to Allah, who calls you. And then again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that we should respond to him and his messenger when they call us to what gives us true life. Istajibu ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Istajibu lillahi walirrasuli idha da'akum lima yuhyikum. O believers, respond to Allah and to the Messenger of Allah when they call you to what will give you true life, the way of Islam. True life, the life of the Akhirah. As the Prophet said, the true life is the life of the Akhirah. Not the life of this dunya. The life of this dunya is a fleeting, temporary life. We're here for a temporary period of time. And then we move on to the permanent life in the hereafter. That's the true life. And that's what we should prepare for. So, the Imam says, respond to him who calls you. And seek help from him, Allah, who is the only one that can help you and save you. Yeah, seek help from him. As in a moral contract we mentioned in Surah Al-Fatiha, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. We, to Allah alone we turn to and seek help from him, because he is the only one who can help us. So the Imam Sayyidi Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani is mentioning this in the sermon. Seek help from him, Allah, who can save you. Take you out of the darkness of ignorance. He's one who can take out of the darkness of ignorance. Cleanse you of the impurity of your soul. Purify your soul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do that. And redeem you from the baseness and misleading temptations, from despair and timidity. Remove all those things from you and replace it with the mahabba of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the mahabba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He told the people in his sermon, your earthly desires are like your foolish friends who keep you off the righteous path and deprive you of the things that you would receive when you follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So your earthly desires, these desires that you have in this dunya, are like your foolish friends. They keep you away from righteousness, from the Sirat Mustaqim, the straight path. So that is how your earthly desire will keep you away from Jannah. How long would you remain slaves of your desires, temptations, greed, pride? In short, this temporary world of the dunya. How long would you remain slaves of your desires? How long would you remain forgetful of the hereafter and of your Creator? The fashion of everything, the first and the last, the manifest and the hidden. Al-awwalu, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes himself, هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن and so on. The different descriptions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How long would you remain forgetful of your Creator? Everything is contained within His grasp. Within the grasp of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is everything. From which emanates the love within your heart, the peace and solace, blessings and favors, all of that that comes from your heart is because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granting you that benefit, that blessing, that ni'mah that you must be mindful of. The Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiyallahu anhu, he also talks about the inner and outer reality. The zahir, the batin. Zahir, the outside. Batin, the inside. Right? The outer reality, the inner reality. How it should be. He says, the entire creation is helpless. Nothing can do good or harm to you. As the Prophet ﷺ says that if all of creation were to gather together to benefit you with something, they would not be able to benefit you with that thing except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. They cannot do anything independent of their own. And the Prophet ﷺ continued in hadith, if the entire creation, everyone in creation, were to gather together to harm you with something, they would never be able to harm you except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in control of everything. Nothing, no one can do anything independent of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he talks about this concept of zahir and batin. The zahir means outer reality, batin the inner reality. He says, the entire creation is helpless. Nothing can do harm or good to you. It is only Almighty Allah who lets a thing be done by you. Or in other words, the will, the irada of Almighty Allah finds expression through you or someone else. That you do the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the scholars have mentioned, it means to do what is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because some people say that they don't know what is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well, no one knows that. But you know from the Aqidah, Imam al-Tahawi mentions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to obey Him. No matter what. He wants us to obey Him. To follow His instructions. And that is how we make this transformation. To live this life of Tawheed in our lives. And don't bother with people what they are doing and rushing to follow them. No. We cannot be like that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already destined, preordained, whatever is going to happen to you. But remember once again, Imam al-Tahawi explained this beautifully in his Aqidah Tahawiyyah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to follow Him. This is what you need to understand. And He does not want you to disobey Him. He wants you to obey Him and to stay away from disobedience. No matter what is happening around us, no matter what other people are saying or doing, you don't follow them. You follow this dictate, this command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We always want to do things which would constitute obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And stay away from disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Almighty Allah has already destined or decreed whatever is going to happen to you, whether it is beneficial or harmful. And the destiny cannot be changed. The destiny cannot be changed. وَلَنْ تَجِدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَبْدِيلًا as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran. Those who are faithful and virtuous set an example for other creation. That as a good person, as a believer, each and every one of you, you must be a good example for other people. There are few among these who have so purified their heart that the interior and exterior selves have become one and the same. Those who have purified themselves for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is an important point that you should be mindful of, which is your interior self, your batin, and your exterior self, your dhahir, are the same. For many people, their external action is different from their internal action. Sometimes what they do in public different from what they do in private. No, it should be the same. It should be good, obedience to Allah. So in public, in front of people, there are some people who would try to impress them, pray long salah and so on, obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then in private, they may not even be praying, let alone short salah. But in public, they're doing long salah. So for people, so people can say, oh, that person is such a religious person, they're praying so long. But then in privacy of their home and so on, they don't even pray. That's dangerous and disastrous. And it leads to terrible downfall. Your outward reality and your inner reality must be the same. The Sheikh is mentioning to his students about this. Even if these people have riches, their inner reality, haqiqah, is never polluted with a worldly attachment. Those people who have dedicated themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even riches and wealth would not cause them to deviate from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so they've attuned their hearts to the ultimate source of power, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Sharia beautifies their exterior, their outward actions. It's in accordance with the Sharia, the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While Tawheed, oneness of Allah, and the wisdom of knowledge is what decorate their interior. The interior then becomes even better. And there are some people who strive for that. The interior becomes better than the exterior, which is opposite from most people. Most people, the exterior is better than the interior. In front of people, they show off. And in privacy of their homes and so on, they do nothing. Or how they treat their family and so on. Different from how they behave on the outside. So this is the important point I want to mention tonight. How Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani responded to the challenges of his time. When you find the difficulties, the spiritual diseases in his time, he responded it through teaching the people the right way and motivating them to do what is right, so they would stay away from what is wrong. And if you have enough people doing that, you change society. And this is what he did. And subhanAllah, many of the things he dealt with are relevant for us today. Relevant for us today. The lessons that he taught his murids, his students, his followers, and so on, they're relevant for us today. And that is why his influence continues in the world today, many centuries after his passing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to follow in the footsteps of Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani radiyallahu anhu. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the blessings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahabas, the Tabi'een, the Awliya, all of them until the Day of Judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be with them in the dunya and to be with them in the akhirah, in the highest levels of Jannah, Jannatul Firdaus, Al-Firdaus Al-A'la, with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the Ahlul Bayt, with the Sahabas, with the Awliya. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of you with that special blessings. Until we meet again, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you in the shade of His divine mercy. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in wa akhir da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا
واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. يا أكرم الخلق ما لمن ألوذ به سواك عند حلول الحديث العمام. يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. وليضيق رسول الله جاهك به إذا الكريم تجلى باسم منتقيم. يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. يا ربي
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بیبی آمینہ کے پول
الله الله جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بیبی آمینہ کے پول
الله الله
جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و غلمہ بھی خوشیاں سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و غلمہ بھی خوشیاں منانے لگے ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی مل گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی
جشن آمد رسول الله
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، عليه صلاة الله. لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، عليه صلاة الله. بها يثبت الإيمان، بها يحصل الأمان، كرر أيها الإنسان. لا إله إلا الله، تكرارها ما أحلى، ما أبهاه ما أعلى، تذني العبد من مولاه. لا إله إلا الله، قد أتانا في الأخبار عن النبي المختار، أن أفضل الأذكار. لا إله إلا الله، جمعت معنى التوحيد ودلت بلا مزيد، كرر أيها المريد. لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، عليه صلاة الله. ذاكي روح لا يشقى، لا ينال فرقا، هي العروة الوثقى. لا إله إلا الله، هي حسنك الحسين، هي ذرك المتين، ذكر رب العالمين. لا إله إلا الله، فيها الفوز والنجاة، فيها كل البركات، تنجي من كل العفات. لا إله إلا الله، بها تمحى السيئات، بها تنمو الحسنات، بها تنال الخيرات. لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، عليه صلاة الله. فيها للسهم دعوى، فيها للتفريق قوى، هي كلمة التقوى. لا إله إلا الله، هي شفاء الصدور، هي نور على نور، ذكر ربك الغفور. لا إله إلا الله، هي النعمة العظمى، هي المقام الأسمى، ليس تبقي على ما. لا إله إلا الله، هي شفاء العلل، فيها إصلاح الخلل، فابخر لا تخشى الملل. لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله.
إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
نور ولا يا حي نور لك الرأي حي
نور ولا يا حي نور لك الرأي حي سارة عالم میں یہ دیکھو کیسا نور چھایا ہے الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله جب تلك یہ چاند تارے جن ملاتے جائیں گے تب تلك جشن ولادت ہم مناتے جائیں گے جب تلك یہ چاند تارے جن ملاتے جائیں گے تب تلك جشن ولادت ہم مناتے جائیں گے نور والا آیا ہے نور لے کر آیا ہے سارے عالم میں یہ دیکھو کیسا نور چھایا ہے الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله نعت محبوب خدا سنتے سناتے جائیں گے يا رسول الله
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
قطب النقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى
الروح له أدنى ثمن قطب اللقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن قد دل على المولى وسما في الفضل إلى أعلى كنن قد دل على المولى وسما في الفضل إلى أعلى كنن وتى في هذا العلم بما قد زاد على الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن معرفة المولى غايته فاتبعه على هذا السنن معرفة المولى غايته فاتبعه على هذا السنن رسول الله وسيلته فاغرف من هاتيك السنن قطب اللقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن وأساس بناء طريقته تطهير القلب من الدرن وأساس بناء طريقته تطهير القلب من الدرن فاسلك بالاسم المفرد يا صوفي وبالحق استعن قطب اللقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن غب وافن عن الأكوان فما يبقى إلا من فيه فني غب وافن عن الأكوان فما يبقى إلا من فيه فني وادخل أبواب الغيب وسل ما شئت وللأسرار سني قطب اللقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن واشرب كأس العرفان وذق سر التوحيد ولا تكن واشرب كأس العرفان وذق سر التوحيد ولا تكن وبحب رجال الله فدن وإمام الكل أبي الحسن قطب اللقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا
واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا أكرم الخلق ما لمن ألوذ به سواك عند أولول الحديث العمام يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم وليرضيك رسول الله جاهك به إذا الكريم تجلى باسم منتقم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بی بی آمینہ کے پول
الله الله جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بی بی آمینہ کے پول
الله الله
جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و غلمہ بھی خوشیاں سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و غلمہ بھی خوشیاں منانے لگے ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی مصطفیٰ کی امین زندگی مل گئی مصطفیٰ کی امین زندگی
رسول الله الله بی بی آمینہ کے
Bismillah, Bismillah. Just let us know, type in the chat if you can hear us now, inshallah. Because there are a couple of people who said there was no sound. So if you can check and let me know. Okay, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, thanks for the admin staff for fixing that issue. And thanks all for those of you who mentioned in the chat that you couldn't hear, so we can try to fix it here on our end. Alhamdulillah. Shukran, Sidi Omar. Abdul-Jabbar Omar from Atlanta, Georgia. So once again, I want to welcome everyone to our daily live stream broadcast. This program, which is coming to you from your Zawiya here at the Islamic Forum. And we thank you for joining us. We hope you can join us every day at 7 p.m. Toronto time. And do remember to tell your family members, relatives, friends, and other Muslims to know about the program. Encourage them to watch the program, sign into the chat, inshallah. They'll benefit and you would receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I was mentioning that we had a wonderful series of programs in the United Kingdom. I just got back yesterday, just in time for our live stream broadcast. Alhamdulillah, last night we had wonderful programs in different cities. Most of the programs were in the north of the country, Manchester, Bradford, and surrounding areas. We had one program in the Midlands, in Birmingham, and that was our final program before I departed from the UK to return back to Canada. And alhamdulillah, there was a brother there, a non-Muslim, a friend of one of the murids. He attended that gathering and he took shahada, he accepted Islam. So that was the last thing we did before returning to Canada. So it was a wonderful blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the programs in the UK culminated with this brother who accepted Islam, took shahada, brother Troy Walden from Birmingham, alhamdulillah. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his tawfiq. We hope inshallah we can get some video footage from that shahada that we would share it with you, inshallah. For the audience in the UK, or brothers and sisters in the US, sorry, in the US, some of you have been asking about our opinion on the elections earlier this week. Well, we have no opinion. I don't like to give my opinion in these matters because I may not know enough of what is happening. So the Sheikh doesn't have to answer everything. He doesn't know everything. But maybe we can hear from you, the brothers and sisters in the US, what you feel about the elections. For those families in Georgia, I understand that there would be a runoff election in December between the two leading candidates because the results were too close to declare one candidate as the victor, as the winner. So you can let us know. I think in these matters, you, those of you in the United States, would know better than us here in Canada about the election results and what you think about it, inshallah. But once again, you know, one of the things I want to remind you of is that during this election process, the campaigning for elections, you have the candidates and their supporters. They go and they meet thousands of people. Every day they spend many hours knocking on doors and trying to convince people to vote for them and or vote for the candidate they're supporting and so on in this way. They spend a lot of resources, a lot of money and so on to reach out to people. And many of the candidates, they spend their own money. So if they're very wealthy, then they would spend more and they have an edge over other candidates because they're wealthy, they can spend millions of dollars for the election campaign, and they usually end up winning because they can advertise in the media and have a stronger campaign and so on. The lesson I want to remind you of that you can learn from this is they are doing their da'wah to their message. But as Muslims, we have to do da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's the best thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares in the Quran, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. You see, who can be better than the one who calls to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So people call to what they believe in, their leader and so on, you know, their imam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to in the Quran, that on the Day of Judgment, people would be looking for their imam, their, meaning their leader. Whoever that leader is, whatever they stand for, whether they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not, whether they believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or not. But the one who is successful is the one who can truly be connected to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And even the other messengers, the other prophets will be doing that. When people go to them and beg them, the other prophets, to intercede for them because it's so difficult in the Day of Judgment, they will say they cannot do it. Go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So don't wait for that Day of Judgment. You should tell people they shouldn't wait for the Day of Judgment to be connected to the Prophet because it's too late then. You cannot do that. It has to be done now in this dunya. Your connection to the Prophet ﷺ, he has to be your imam, your leader, the one that you're following. So this is why your da'wah is so very important, that you would invite people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to believe in Allah, believe in the Prophet ﷺ. And one of the best ways, perhaps the most convenient and easiest ways, is invite them to watch this program. Because when they watch this program, they'll get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you would get the blessings for doing so. So it's a wonderful lesson that people for the dunya, like these candidates for the elections, I mean, for US elections, midterm elections, earlier this week on Tuesday, they're still counting some of the constituencies, the votes and so on. So the elections, the results are not final as yet. All these things. But they work so hard for the dunya, you know, to win elections, to be the winning candidates, to become a member of the House of Representatives, to become senator in the US Senate and so on. They work so hard. You've seen this. But what about you working for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? To invite people to Allah, to engage in this da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should spend some time every day doing this. And technology has made it convenient for us. You know, your phone, you have your phone, you can be calling your friends, your relatives, other Muslims, you know, try to get to know them, call them, talk to them, tell them about this program, let them watch the program, they'll get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They learn more about the true Sunni way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this way. So just as those people work hard for the dunya, you should work hard for the akhirah. This is a very beautiful lesson we can learn from these elections. It's in the media a lot, the elections early this week in the United States, because they're saying that what happens in the United States affect the rest of the world. And it's true. With respect to the dunya, this world. But our concern is also for the akhirah. So you can work very hard. So the programs in the UK now, alhamdulillah, were very nice. The main event was on Sunday of this week in Bradford, at the Grand Broadway Theater, a premier theater facility in the city of Bradford, capacity of 1,500. And the brothers and sisters, Maurice, worked very hard to get people to come out. And it was a paid event. You had to pay to get a ticket to attend. And it was sold out. You know, so many people were there from different places across the UK, and a scattering of people from different countries. Canada, United States, and some European countries like France, alhamdulillah. So a wonderful event, And we every day we were having programs in different cities in the UK, in the north of the country, as I mentioned. We didn't do any programs in the south of the country on this particular visit. And alhamdulillah, the result was amazing. As I said, it culminated on a final program that we did in the UK with Shahada. There's a brother, Troy Walden, who accepted Islam. He took Shahada, alhamdulillah. So, great blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do remember to put your information in the chat, inshallah. I would go through the chat and welcome everyone momentarily. We want to recognize all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. And we hope you can respond to the special appeal tonight for Jum'ah, the Jum'ah appeal. To respond, you go to our website, islamforumonline.com. The link is in the chat. And you go to the donation page, and then there are several buttons for different categories of donation. You can click on the Jum'ah appeal, and there are two options here. You can make a one-time donation for this week, or you can sign up for the weekly donation, which is the preferred option. We request you and recommend that you do so. Sign up for the weekly donation for Jum'ah. You can do so tonight after we conclude our live stream broadcast. Whatever you'd like to do every week, you get the blessings continuously, inshallah. So we want to make dua for all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them and all of you. Also, we have the special event on coming Sunday, the 13th of November, just 2-3 days away. Today is Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at 12 noon here at Islamic Forum. Remembrance Day Maulid, a special event for the IFC family. So we want to encourage all of you to join us 12 noon here at Islamic Forum for the Remembrance Day Maulid. There is no admission fee, no admission charge. It's free program. We have a full course lunch. Full course lunch at the beginning of the program for you to enjoy, but you have to register to attend. So you can type in the chat, let us know you're coming, and the names of other family members who are coming as well. Do reach out to your family members, your relatives, your friends, other Muslims, you know, tell them about the program, invite them to come to the program, and let them register, or you can register them on their behalf. Just type in the chat their names, or email us their names and so on, who are coming, so we can add them to the registration form to allow them entry into the program on Sunday, 12 noon. Also, we want to encourage you to come early. Come on time, because we are starting the program with lunch. So don't eat too much on Sunday. You come to the program, so there'll be lots of food for you to eat, wide variety and so on. Our last family program, which was done for the Maulid or Rasul event and Thanksgiving weekend also, we did a brunch program and everyone enjoyed it. So this program is a lunch program that we are doing for this particular gathering of the IFC family that we want all of you to come out. So do remember to reach out to others and invite them to come to the program and register their names in the chat or send us an email with their names, inshallah. So Sunday, we look forward to seeing all of you on Sunday. And those in other countries, other cities, we hope you can join us sometime in the future. If any one of you will be in Toronto this weekend, please join us on Sunday, 12 noon. And if you're not able to come, then you'll miss out on the delicious full course lunch and a wonderful educational program that we will share with you. And then we're having some games, extracurricular activities. After the program concludes, we'll have a dessert, wonderful dessert, wide variety, and you enjoy your dessert and engage in some games and board games and so on. Sisters playing among themselves, brothers playing among themselves, inshallah, as a wonderful way for us to get to know one another more and more, inshallah. So all of that happening on Sunday, and I'll be giving a more detailed review report on my recent visit to the UK, inshallah. So look forward to seeing all of you. We also want to remind you of the Surah Al-Ikhlas Khatam. Please enter your information in the chat. at the top of the chat, there are several messages from the admin staff. Please go through those messages and respond accordingly, inshallah. And the book that we're featuring in this season of Rabia, and we're now in the second half of the season of Rabia. We finished the first half, Rabia al-Awwal, now we're in Rabia Thani. So the book that we're featuring is Blessings of Salawat, beautiful book, available on Amazon.com. You can get your copies. The link is at the top of the chat. Click on the link to get a copy for yourself, and you can get additional copies for your family, friends, relatives, your loved ones, like that, inshallah. It's a wonderful gift to give to them in this season of Rabia. You encourage them to recite Salawat, and you get great blessings in this dunya and in the akhirah. So we encourage you to get a few copies of this book, inshallah. The link is in the chat. Click on the link to get a book. And we also want to remind you of the Saturday Islamic School here at the Islamic Forum, every Saturday you have the school from 10 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. So bring your children 10 a.m. on Saturday to register them for the Islamic School. And we have classes for children from grades 1 to grade 12 that you can bring them and register them and tell others, other Muslim families you know, if they have children in that age group, they can bring them on Saturday, 10 a.m., register them for the Islamic School. May Allah bless you, bless them, inshallah. So at the top of the chat today, we have Sister Janna Taylor from Richmond, Virginia. Welcome, Sister Janna Taylor. Thanks for joining us. Second in the chat today, we have Sidi Shamir, Sidi Samir, Sidi Amir, Sidi Shabir, Sidi Shafir, Sidi Shaziz, Sidi Sadiqa, Sidi Alima, Sidi Medina from Queens, New York, in the United States. Welcome to all of you. Alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us. And we also welcome Sidi Hasib, Sidi Asia, Sidi Asil, Sidi Nushin, Sidi Aram, Sidi Akif. Welcome to all of you. Wishing Rabiul Thani and Maulid Mubarak greetings to everyone. Bibi Ibrahim, Brother Muhammad Ibrahim and family from Pembroke Pines in Florida. Welcome. Alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us. Sister Abida and Sister Shamaila. And family from Manchester, United Kingdom, welcome. Today recited Juz number 30 to complete the Khatam of the Quran. So Alhamdulillah, we are blessed with another Khatam for the Islamic Forum Quran project. Congratulations, Mubarak, to Sister Abid and Sister Shamaila and their family for doing the Khatam, for completing another Khatam. And then for each and every one of you who have made your niyyah to join the Islamic Forum Quran project, then you share in the blessings as well, inshallah. Inshallah. So we encourage all of you to make your niyyah, join the IFC Quran project. The first step is to recite at least one page of the Quran every day. Start from the beginning and continue until you finish the Quran. As Zisab and Shamail and the family did tonight, they did their khatam of the Quran. Congratulations. Alhamdulillah. Siti Hafiza Hussein, Sidi Azam and family from Brampton, welcome to all of you. Alhamdulillah. Sidi Naeem Al-Faisal, Siti Oveen Al-Faisal from New York, United States, welcome to all of you. Alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. Siti Mari McGee, Siti Bilal, Siti Elijah from Richmond, Virginia. In the United States, welcome, alhamdulillah. Very good, alhamdulillah. And Siti Marmagi says, Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings, Maulid Mubarak greetings, and Joe Mubarak greetings. Your beloved Faisal and the Sheikh Faisal, your beloved Noor parents and family, the Maurice Admin staff, and the IFC family. Shukran Siti Aliyah, Siti Mariam McGee from Richmond, Virginia, for remembering everyone, and especially for mentioning my parents and family. May Allah subhanahu bless you, bless your entire family. Inshallah. Very, very nice. And so three greetings tonight. Rabia Thani for the month, Maulid Mubarak for the event, and Jum'a Mubarak for Jum'a, night of Jum'a. You should do this today, tomorrow, and then tomorrow night. Inshallah. Siti Raja Khan, Siti Tariq from Scarborough, Sis Yasmin from Bowmanville. Welcome to all of you. Alhamdulillah, thanks for joining us. Sister Bibi Farida Babzan Omar from Pembroke Pines in Florida, United States, welcome, alhamdulillah. Sister Bibi Zamina Razak from Cotton Tree Village, West Coast Barbies in Guyana, South America, welcome, thanks for joining us. Auntie Betty Amina Dean from Toronto, welcome. Salawat update, recited 6,000 today for 269,000. So your class recited 6,000 out of 20,000. Alhamdulillah, very good. Sister Zairul and family from Toronto, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Sidi Asha Bakas. Sidi Sherry Bakas, Sidi Rajab, and the entire family from Brothers Village, East Bank, Barbies in Guyana, South America, welcome. Thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. And wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak, Mal Mubarak, and Jum'a Mubarak greetings, Faisal and Sheikh Faisal, build no appearance on family, Maurice, Admin Saf, and the IFC family. Shukran Sidi Asha for remembering everyone. Complete Weird Alarm twice today after Fajr and Maghrib, and then one page of the Quran reach up to chapter 9. Very good, Sidi Asha, making wonderful progress. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. We also want to welcome, we have news from Auntie Betty. She completed 20,000 Sutta Ikhlas. Very good. That's amazing. 20,000, 20 shares of Sutta Ikhlas. Great achievement. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Alhamdulillah. Siti Halima Khan and family. From Markham, welcome. Thanks to John, you make do for you and family is requested, inshallah. Sidi Maulana Tariq Al Faisal, Sidi Kareen Al Faisal from QREP in Trinidad in West Indies, welcome. Alhamdulillah. And Sidi Halima says today recited 400 Sutta class, completed 6,000 of the 6,000 pledge. So, alhamdulillah, completed that pledge and you're taking another share of another 1,000. Very good. Very good. Take another share, inshallah. Every day you can recite it. It will be very nice. You get great blessings, inshallah. Sid Maulana Tariq says, Rabia Thani Mubarak, Maulana Mubarak, and Jum'a Mubarak. Greetings. Sayyid Sheikh Faisal, no parents and family. Admin Saf, IFC family, fellow Murids. Alhamdulillah. Shukran. Sid Maulana Tariq for remembering everyone. Mention my parents and family. May Allah bless you. Bless your entire family, inshallah. Sister Ullah Rahman from Toronto. Welcome. Sister Zareen Bashiruddin, but Mustafa Bashiruddin from Markham. Welcome, Migdo, for you as requested, inshallah. Sidi Tahir Mailoud from Tourcouring in north of France. So, our Murid in France. Sidi Tahir Mailoud. Welcome, Sidi Tahir. Thanks for joining us all the way from France. We hope you can join us every night, 7 p.m. Toronto time. There's a time difference. It's much later for you, but it's a good sacrifice. You get great blessings. So, after you finish Isha, you can pray Isha. It's early now. Then you get some rest, inshallah, and set your alarm to wake up at night for the program. You can watch a program. You can also do tahajjud, inshallah. You can do some dhikr like that. and watch the program. And if you can please reach out to other Muslims there, family, relatives, friends, and encourage them to watch the program, recite Wird Alam. Let them start reciting Wird Alam. When they're doing that, then they're ready to take Bayah, and you can let us know. So welcome, wonderful job you're doing, inshallah. And do keep in contact with Sidi Samir Faisal. He updates me regularly about his communication with you, inshallah. Very nice. Sister Shireen Jabbar and family from Scarborough, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Sidi Zahid Ihsan and family from San Diego, welcome. So Sidi Zahid, it's Thursday night, so remember the greetings. Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings, Maulid Mubarak greetings, and Jummah Mubarak greetings. Three greetings tonight, Thursday night, and tomorrow Jummah, and then tomorrow night during Lightning broadcast, three greetings. And the rest of the week, two greetings. So do try to remember all of that, inshallah. Sidi Sharif Al-Faisal and family from Scarborough, welcome. Thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. Sidi Ali Khan and family from Ottawa, welcome. Thanks for remembering the three greetings. Sidi Sharif also, Sharif Faisal, remembering the three greetings. Sidi Ansar Afridi from Karachi, Pakistan. Welcome all the way from Pakistan, Karachi. Thanks for joining us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Alhamdulillah. And Sidi Mustafa Bashiruddin, thanks for your feedback. Brother Ahsan Shabir family from Italy, welcome all of you from Italy, thanks for joining us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, make dua for you and your family as requested, inshallah. Sayyid Ismail Faisal, Sayyid Fatima Zahra, Grandma Jam from Brampton, welcome to all of you. Wishing you Mubarak, Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings. Remember the third greetings, Maulid Mubarak greetings as well. Salwat Project, today 2200 for a total of 70,000 out of the 100,000 pledge for the season of Rabia. Alhamdulillah, very nice. Be welcome as well. CD Dr. Tahir Chowdhury from California, welcome. Thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. And thanks, Sidi Dr. Tahir Chowdhury, for your feedback, inshallah, for the different projects. Sidi Naim Ali from Mississauga, welcome. Sister Shireen Shaw from Brampton, welcome. Alhamdulillah, thanks for your feedback on a different project. Very good. Sidi Abdi Jabbar Umar and Sidi Mona from Atlanta, Georgia, welcome. Thanks for joining us. It's Bibi Rasul and family from Etopico, welcome. Alhamdulillah. Sidi Amar Faisal and family from London, welcome. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Thanks, Sidi Mariam McGee, for your feedback on the election. Sidi Rani Rahman from Mississauga, welcome. Alhamdulillah. Very nice. So those are the brothers and sisters in the chat, inshallah. We would make dua now for everyone. Alhamdulillah. For all our donors, for all those who are participating in the Surat al-Ikhlas Khatam, and everyone who registered for the special Remembrance Day Maulid, the special gathering for the IFC family we're having on Sunday. We hope you can all attend, inshallah. So make do for all those registered, for all the organizers, all the donors, sponsors, make do for all of them, inshallah. And we hope everyone in the GTA area can come to the Islamic Forum for the physical program on Sunday starting at 12 noon, inshallah. So, and do tell all the Muslims, you know, family, relatives, friends, and other Muslims, tell them the program, encourage them to watch your program. to come to the event on Sunday, 12 noon, the Remembrance Day Maulid, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you. Do remember the donation for Jum'ah for this week. You can make a special donation for the Jum'ah appeal for this week, inshallah. Also, the sunnahs for Jum'ah, it's on our Facebook page that you can get all of that, inshallah. And tomorrow for Jummah, those in the GT area, the Greater Toronto Area, please come to the Islamic Forum. Adhan is at 1 p.m. Khutbah starts at 1:30 every Friday, no time change. And those of you who are not able to attend, like you're from other city or a country, then please join us online. The online broadcast, it's on the same channel, the YouTube channel, starting at 1 p.m., inshallah. So do come early. And even if you're at home, make sure you dress properly, do your ghusl, full complete bath, and so on. Prepare for Jummah as if you're going out to a special Jummah occasion, because it is special. So even though you're at home, you can be here physically with us, you join us online, you be mindful about that. For those who are coming, make sure you dress for Jummah. You look your best, inshallah. So look forward to seeing all of you tomorrow for Jummah, 1 p.m. Toronto time. The Jummah program starts with Adhan, then you get a chance to do your Sunnah, your Nafil, recite Quran, do your Dhikr, make your Dua, and then 1:30 we start Khutbah, listen to Khutbah, and you pray Salatul Jummah with us, inshallah. So kindly raise hands and join me in Dua. Allahumma Ameen. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين لا إله إلا الله الحليم الكريم سبحان الله رب العرش العظيم والحمد لله رب العالمين ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما ربنا هب لنا من لدنك ذرية طيبة إنك سميع الدعاء ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين آمين آمين. Do remember to type آمين in the chat for the dua so you can increase your blessings. You get more blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do also remember to click on the thumbs up button to like the program. Please do so every night. It helps in the analytics for the program. We thank you for joining us tonight. We hope you can join us every night at 7 p.m. Toronto time. Do remember to reach out to your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know. Tell them about the program. Encourage them to watch your program. Remind them to watch your program and sign into the chat. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program and you'll receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A special night tonight, night of Jummah, Thursday night, tomorrow, special day of Jummah. So I want to wish each and every one of you Jummah Mubarak greetings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you always in the shade of His special mercies. Until we meet again, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.